Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making hot Swiss bacon dip with Melba Rounds. It's the first hot dip I think I've made in Betty's Kitchen, so I was just looking for something a little different to give you.
I want to start out by using some Swiss cheese. And this bag has 1½ cups. I actually need 2 cups, so this is a half cup that I got from another bag. So we're going to put that in our bowl right here. That's quite a bit. And then we have a block, an 8-ounce block of cream cheese. This is at room temperature. You can either cut it in cubes like I've done here and let it sit, or you can put it in the microwave. But just put in 8 ounces worth of softened cream cheese. This is a pretty big dip. Next we have mayonnaise, and I use mayo free. We need 1/4 cup, and have it sitting back here where you probably couldn't see it, but we're just going to add that in. Let's not do any mixing yet because we have so many things we would have to mix a lot of different times. And there we go with our mayonnaise. And you'll see a product here that probably is fairly new on the grocery shelves. This is real bacon bits, and this package is 3 ounces. Hold on to the bottom end of it and sprinkle in the top part of it, leaving about half of the pack. But again, that's really up to you. Now at this point, I am going to start combining because I have some green onions here that will be going in, and if I combine this by actually using the fork to press this like I'll need to get it the softened cream cheese mixed with the Swiss cheese, I would be just mangling those green onion tops. So we don't want to do that. Those will go in last and be gently folded in.
This is what your bacon Swiss dip will look like when you have blended all of those ingredients that we mentioned. But there's still that one additional ingredient, which is green onion. Now I took a bunch of onions like this, and about this amount after they were washed, I used scissors. I hold them down here close to where I'm going to cut, and you can just cut like this and gradually get up to the point where you're cutting all of
that. How it's going to look when I put them in, so I'm going to just put part of them in, maybe half of them in, and stir that around. And if it looks like that's enough, then we'll go with that. We don't want it overly flavored with onion. And when you're dealing with bunches of onion like that, you don't have a really good measurement of whether you're getting 1/4 cup or 1/3 cup or what. So we'll just go by eyesight on this. And it's looking to me like the onion is a little scant for the other flavors that we have here and the binder, which is the cream cheese and the Swiss cheese. So I think we can go ahead and put more, but this is kind of how it's going to look before it goes into a baking dish. So I have just a regular Pyrex pie dish here, and I think this is good enough, so I'm going to just pour it in and then smooth it out.
So here we have all of our Swiss bacon dip in just a regular Pyrex baking dish. And we're going to make a topping for it, and then we'll put it in the oven. The topping is going to be composed of Ritz crackers and butter. And what I'm doing with the Ritz crackers is getting them into crumbs, and you've seen me do this many times before. You put some crackers. This would be maybe 2/3 of one of those inner tubes of crackers. And make sure you close the top there. This is a gallon size Ziploc plastic bag, and then use a rolling pin just to go over it and make it into fine crumbs. And these crumbs don't have to be really, really fine because it's not like we're trying to coat chicken or fish or anything like that. It doesn't really have to stick like it does to meats if you're using it as a breading.
I have 2 tablespoons of melted butter here, and I'm going to just put some of this in, and I'll just kind of judge as I go as to how much of the crumbs I'm going to need in order for that to make a nice buttery topping. If I use up all my butter, then I don't really need to put more in. I think we can use just a little bit more here. So just play this by ear. If it looks right to you, then just stop adding. But you want it to have a consistency where it kind of clings together because of the melted butter. And it's a little bit different consistency of just the plain crumbs themselves. So you can see this is what it looks like. It's just kind of buttery looking when you're finished. And you usually will use your hands like this because there's no better way to get that combined. And when you have it like that, then you can go over to your casserole dish or pie dish, whatever you have used for your dip, and just over the top sprinkle as much of this as you like. If you don't want all of it, then you can put less. Try to make it fairly
even.
This
is going to go into the oven, 350 degrees, and I will keep checking on it. When it starts getting bubbly and the top starts getting browned up, that's when I'll bring it out, and then we will use our Melba Rounds to dip into it. It's going to be a great dip.
Here is our hot bacon Swiss dip. Straight from the oven, it's still sizzling, and you know it's done when you see it is bubbling a little around the edges and it's light golden brown. You can leave it a little longer if you want to. This has been 15 minutes at 350 degrees. Now you can use any type of snack cracker or chip with this. I think the perfect complement is a Melba snack or Melba round. And this happens to be a sea salt flavor and it's whole grain. So you have a lot of opportunities to make changes according to your taste. But what I would do would be to give my guest or myself a little serving dish like this and then some rounds, just take a couple, and you can actually dip right in here and you can see that you're going to have a luscious bite to eat right there. Or alternatively, if you want your guests to dip out what they would like on their plate, then they have their own private portion. I want to show you the texture here. And they can dip as they like here. It's gonna be a great dip for a party or just if you wanna have something special in the evening yourself or at lunch or breakfast or anytime.